Division Bill Spartanburg has issued a tornado warning for Western Mecklenburg County in the Piedmont of North Carolina, Eastern Gaston County in the Piedmont of North Carolina, Northeastern York County in Upstate South Carolina, until 3:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 3:01 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado was located 10 miles southeast of Gastonia, or near town of Lake Wiley, moving northeast at 50 miles per hour.
Oh, it's too late already. The storm's already here. This is a timed data release, set to be released just a few days after Gator finally betrays Ralph. Because if there's one thing that I'm well known for, it's never letting someone get away. And I'm sure Gator has deluded himself into thinking he's untouchable and he would always get away. But no. You see, we've known who he was the whole time. I've known who he was the whole time. And I merely tolerated his existence because it was amusing to see someone so pathetic suck up to Ralph and do anything for adoration and to be popular and in the limelight. And, you know, it's almost like all of Ralph's friends have done that. And I'm sure now they're all going to join hands the minute Gator finally turns, and they're all going to pat themselves on the back and pretend like they didn't suck his fucking dick for years for a modicum of money that they could have made more working at Walmart. So at this high point for Gator, when he feels like he's untouchable because he knows that Ralph is too much of a little bitch to actually do anything, I think it's time to come in and set the record straight about who Gator really is. And he's going to go and say, oh, well, this isn't me, guys. It's just Zoom making shit up. So I guess I'm just going to have to drop some hard facts into who he really is. So let's roll that beautiful bean footage. Now I know all the retards at Kiwi Farms and all the idiots in Cow are going to fuck this up because, you know, they never actually find anybody and they like to pride themselves as geniuses, but, you know, they'll go off on this war path towards this other person that kind of looks like Gator, but it's not actually him. This is Gator. Captain Steelbeard. See, Gator threw you guys all off by pretending that he had a computer science degree or he was in a computer science program. In reality, he was an award-winning student film director with an interest in film, which is exactly why he works at a grocery store. And now, for the final exciting release of Gator's identity. You see, he wasn't actually Shannon Gaines or Nicholas or any of the other fucking people he said he was. His actual name is Brian Holloman, and now I release the truth.
Welcome to another installment of Myths and Mysteries. I'm your host, Richard Hunt. On tonight's episode, a student film project goes wrong, and an internet myth is brought to life.
Okay, this scene is where you two find the dead body, and I want you to walk, to basically look like you're...
Greenville, North Carolina, a college town nestled along the banks of the Tar River. It is here that our tale begins. An amateur video contest is underway, and one student has picked out the perfect location, or so he thought.
So what we were tasked with was a simple movie competition where everybody was given camera equipment and microphones and computers and the software. And, you know, I really wanted to get into films and working on films, and so I thought, you know, I might as well, you know, try something a little more cerebral and thought-provoking. That's pretty much what started it. I had no idea what I was getting into.
All right. Action.
What do we got here, rookie?
Well, it looks like, looks like a drug accident. You might have tripped over something. It's, and no pulse or anything, so.
How long have you been on the force?
About a year.
Hold on a second, guys. I'm getting a little bit of static in this shot.
Here we go! Dust in the wind, yeah! Rest in peace, Alex!
Damn, dude.
Oh, dust in the wind. Basketball Americans pissed on our ashes. How do you feel about that?
Okay, we got the picture back. I don't know what happened there. Some kind of weird interference, but okay. Yeah, I want you to basically just kind of pat the dead body, act like you're looking for
identification
or, you know, where the injury was at, and just basically just kind of go from there.
Hey guys, hold on a second.
There's somebody over there. Halloween's, it's not Halloween yet. What are you doing?
It was something that, you know, none of us really could explain. It was just standing there, and at first I thought somebody was, you know, drunk on, you know, nearing Halloween, and that they were just, you know, trying to, you know, goof on everybody. But that's when things got worse.
It's at this point, I bet you all feel pretty trash now. You spent years looking for someone that doesn't exist. And I know that Ralph's gonna eagerly try to hold this over Gator's head for a long time, but this gunt is just too big to hold back. So let's just look deeper into his college career, which has nothing to do with computer science.
Hi, I'm Brian Holloman, and I worked on the Myths and Mysteries movie, based around Slenderman, you know, for the contest. And, you know, one thing people might wonder is, you know, Slenderman's kind of an overdone thing on the internet. You know, why do a movie about Slenderman? And the reason that I chose this particular topic is because I wanted to kind of delve into the idea that, you know, perhaps the belief of something, you know, supernatural can make it real. And, you know, it's a theme played up by Neil Gaiman and American Gods that, you know, both good and evil entities gain power by people believing that they're real. And so, you know, with the internet and access to all this information and people making stuff up, you know, perhaps though people start to believe the stuff that they read on the internet.
And that right there sums up the entire persona of Gator. Brian Holloman, now unmasked. He's completely delusional, and he lives a life of delusion and lies about everything, all as a giant cope to protect him from the reality that he is a complete fucking loser. And so is Ralph, and so are all his co-hosts. They are a obscure, money-hungry, backstabbing group of people that will fuck each other over for a dime and be back the next day for a nickel. And it's just pathetic, which is exactly why I walked away from all of this. But I did have to come back just this one last time to kick this little retard back into the hole where he belongs. So, here's Gator's information.